So again, we're splitting hairs here. Let's talk about how these saws are equipped right now. The 462, I've got a Canon filter with the outerwares on there. Cover, yeah, it's a little chewed up. But that's R&D. I mean, it's how you learn, man. You know, there's no book. You just have to do it. You make your mistakes and you carry on. I've got a pair of 064 dogs on there, ported cylinder, tuned intake, what I call a tuned intake, what I call a tuned exhaust. You know, maybe you don't recognize it, that's fine. And on the 462, I've got a nice 462C, I've got a nice Canon bar on there with a steel RS. And Husqvarna, she's pretty much stock except for the tube exhaust. Wrap panel bars, bigger cover. And let's get into something right away. When I say you're splitting hairs, you are. But what I found is that Husqvarna may give you a little bit better excuse me, better value for the dollar. You know, you want a steel 462C, to my knowledge, you're going to pay. Husqvarna? Well, I'll just give you a real quick example. I want to put a wrap handlebar on the steel. Okay? So you go into your steel dealer and go through the whole nine yards and, it's a hundred and something bucks. I don't know what it is, 159, 170. Now, is it worth it? Yes, because you're gonna get a quality product that lasts forever. But you contrast it with Husqvarna, they give you a 3/4 wrap panel bar, dogs, and a bigger clutch cover, higher discharge clutch cover. And it does make a difference. So again, we're splitting hairs here, you know, and I'm not even talking about the state of tune that much, but we're splitting hairs between the two saws. All things being equal, what's my opinion? You're splitting hairs, they're going to cut, but for dollar, I would say, with what I know, and tomorrow some guy could tell me, oh yeah, you could buy a steel for, you know, this, so I would change my opinion, but when I look at dollar for dollar, the Husqvarna might be a better value. Now, we come back 2 years from now, and I put 500, 1,000 hours on each saw, well, my opinion might change. You know, I don't know, to be honest with you. I haven't run them that long to give you an objective viewpoint. I'm just saying the initial cost, the Husqvarna seems like it's a little more economical. As far as performance goes, given the same amount of work and time and effort, I think you can get a little more out of the Husqvarna. And again, I'm splitting hairs. We're talking, you know, tenths of a second, 4 or 5, half a second faster through a lot. I mean, it's not really going to matter. I mean, unless you're comparing it to a stock saw, and then either one of these, you know, you're going to have the truck filled up and the other guy's going to be farting around there, you know. There's no contest, no doubt. Yeah.